Absolutely amazing to have you here with us, and congratulations on this film. Can you start by talking a little bit about what it was about this moment in human history, this people, this place, that made you want to bring it to screen in this very vivid and impactful way?
It's a great question. It really was the article that Luke Mogelson wrote in The New Yorker. It was some of the best journalism I've ever read, and it wasn't... I hadn't finished the article before I realized I was desperate to write this story, not only write it, but direct it, if only to show a much larger audience who these people are, how they've been forced to live for the last 3 years, really a minute-by-minute existence, where they can go from gun battle to jokes to cigarettes back to gun battle in a matter of minutes, literally. And I just I thought it was a once in a lifetime opportunity, and to partner with producers like Joe and Anthony, who never flinched when I said we should shoot it in Arabic with an all regional cast from that part of the world who have some connection to this story. Maybe they haven't fought in Mosul or lived it, but they have family. They're from war torn parts. It was just. Yeah, I mean, it's why I want to make movies in the first place.
People around the world are familiar with the events of Mosul, but can you talk a little bit about the specific human story and putting a human face on those global events?
Yeah, start with the SWAT team. I mean, local cops in Mosul, who a lot of these ISIS terrorists... grew up with these guys. They were cops and robbers long before there was an ISIS to join. So a lot of these guys who flocked to ISIS when they invaded were criminals who had been arrested by the cops that made up the SWAT team before the war started. So there was a man I talked to who was an Iraqi Golden Division commando who told me a story about... they were in a firefight, and the guy next to him turned as they were reloading and said, "We're shooting at my cousin." He recognized his cousin on the other side of the line. And I just, you know, it made me think of the American Civil War. It made me think of how brutal politics and religion and combat can be. They can quite literally shred families. And that I would love to think that I would have a similar level of courage and bravery were I ever to find myself in a similarly hellish situation. I just wanted to, you know, show people that this exists there and that this idea we have of Iraq is really incomplete unless you know about people like the Nineveh SWAT team.
In terms of politics, people automatically assume that a film about Iraq and about military conflict in general must have some form of political message attached to it, must have a viewpoint on that conflict as a whole.
Yeah.
Can you talk about the extent to which you feel this film does or does not have that?
I really tried to just stay away from the politics of it. I mean, in large part because the politics are pretty cut and dry. It's a group of decent human beings fighting back one of the ugliest, most retrograde groups that I think the world has seen since Nazi Germany. I mean, just a vicious, hateful, sexist, murderous group of people. So I didn't want to delve into the political outside of just the subject matter of war. So I just tried to show how these people have to live their lives and the things they're doing to fight back to get some modicum of peace and prosperity and health and love back into those lives. But no, I didn't elaborate on the politics, which is something for me because I, you know, those are typically the things I like to write and every once in a while throw my two cents in, for better or worse. Yeah.
How much does it mean to you to have two master storytellers like the Russo brothers throwing their support behind this project and producing?
It wouldn't have been possible without them. I mean, truly... I can't think of anybody else who would have made this movie in the way we made it. And the fact that they never needed to be cajoled, they were on board the moment I said, this is how I think we should do it. And I truly not to blow too much smoke, but I truly don't know of another couple, another crew that would have done this way. And they're just two of the most honest, wonderful, well-meaning, warm people, straightforward but warm, that I've ever come across. And yeah, I mean, it sounds, you know, basic, but it truly is the case that this movie's not possible without them.
I think it's really important these days because it's the first time an American Hollywood big movie is done entirely in Arabic, and I think it's really, really important for now the boundaries to back off a little bit, and so we see the things we have in common more than the differences. My character is named Kawa, and he's a young police officer that he's been taken by the SWAT and is going to leave an incredible journey in one day.
And when you first read this script, what was it that most spoke to you about the project? What was it that resonated with you most as a storyteller?
Storytelling, I think the fact that probably it was so intense in one day, the writing of Matthew, Mike Granahan was absolutely writing. I was blown away. And the fact, too, that it was entirely in Arabic. It has never been done before. Entire cast from the Arab Bowl. So it was actually a chance and a blast for us to do that project.
I mean, we often hear that word representation and authenticity, those words mentioned. Why do you think for a project like this, those are so crucially important in the way you're describing?
I mean, I think authenticity is how you touch people's heart. I mean, you know, I couldn't see it differently, you know?
When people watch this film here at TIFF and around the world, what are you most hoping overall they take away from the experience?
I mean, I hope they're touched. I hope they literally see this beautiful story and what these people has been through. And I just, you know, for every movie experience, you just want people to be touched and feel good emotion and just to think after the movie of what the kind of world we're living in and try to make it a better place to live.
In terms of good emotions, can you describe how it feels to have the film supported by two producers who in their own right are such master storytellers, the Russo brothers?
I mean, it's a blast. This movie was an important story to tell. It could have been done without them. So, I mean, it's just fantastic to have them on board, and they're great people and they support the movie, and I mean, they're just great artists.
I think it's very important for everybody. It's a truth story. It's talking about people they should to fight for their family and for their kids, for their land, for their country. It doesn't matter if it was in my country or in the other country. It has to be told, this story. It's about everybody. It's about our families. That's why we be here. Why we have to be here. Matthew, he's amazing guy. He's amazing person. He's never yelling on the set, and we love to work with him every day. We have a hug in the morning. We have a hug after we finish shooting. He's a very, very nice person, and he's a very good worker too. He's a very, very nice director too. I play Major Jassim. He's a leader for the Iraqi SWAT team who fight to liberate his city and to protect their families from the ISIS.
And how important do you think it is that this film is in Arabic and has that authenticity to it, with Arabic actors starring in these roles?
I think it's very important for all the Arab country. I want to say thank you for all the director, the producer, to show our story for all the world. It's very important, not just for the Arab country, it's important for all the world.
And when the rest of the world sees this film, what are you most hoping an audience takes away from the experience of the film overall?
I think the important thing, like what I say, it's everybody he has to do like that. It's about our family, it's about our land. And it's a great, you have to fight for it, and you have to tell this story for everybody.
Okay, so I just want to introduce myself. I'm Muhimin Mahbuba. I play the character of Amir, the number one sniper. And my character is just a younger guy, plays like the role, and he's affected with everyone. Like, we're brothers in this team. We're all brothers in this team with Kawa, with Major Jasim. We're all just brothers, united. And I'm just representing one of the strongest, bravest people. And it's an honor to represent one of these people that actually fought this war and portray it in Arabic and be the actual image of how it's supposed to. That's such a true honor, and I'm humbled to be a part of this movie. When audience get to see this like film, honestly, I'm yet to see it, but I know it's very, very, very realistic, and it portrays the true image. There was instances where I actually felt like I was in Iraq, and for living there for a couple of years and everything. So when audience, I want audience to have the empathy and feel how the Iraqi SWAT team of Nineveh or of Mosul actually were. And this is the true image.
What do you think is going to surprise people the most about this film? Because I think when people hear what it's about, they think about Iraq, they think about this conflict, they carry with them a weight of political and personal expectations.
See, I feel like when they see this film and how it unites all of Iraq, from we have someone from Kurdistan, we have multiple race, religions and everything. So this movie is actually putting it together, showing how Iraq is a unity of people and a community. And the fact that it portrays it in Arabic shows the true language and how the true actual dialect every Iraqi would speak. So I hope they truly enjoy this and put their political like stereotypes aside and just open it with an open heart and just view it and see how it is.
So for my brother and I, from the moment we read this movie is based on an article that appeared in the New Yorker, written by Luke Mogelson. And Luke embedded himself with an Iraqi SWAT team in Mosul as they were trying to clear the city of ISIS. And it was such a beautiful and resonant story and heart-wrenching story told from the Iraqi point of view, because he painted such a simple portrait of all of these members of the SWAT team. And I think that was it was an eye-opener for Joe and I in the sense of looking at the conflict there, looking at the problem there from a purely Iraqi point of view. And we felt that was a very important story to tell. It was a fresh story to tell. And we're very happy to be able to play a part in bringing that story to audiences. My brother and I feel are very, like it's a mission for us. You know, we've seen what the power of storytelling can do. We've seen how the power of storytelling can cross cultures and go global and bring all of us together into a conversation about movies and what's important in life and what's meaningful and resonant. So we just want to keep feeding that conversation, feeding that experience globally. And I think this movie, Mosul, gives us a very, very special story from a really specific and important part of the world, Iraq, in a way that we haven't been able to celebrate before. And we look forward to like audiences being able to share in that. So Matt Carnahan, for a very long time, has been one of my brothers and my favorite writers in Hollywood. He's an amazing screenwriter, one of the best in Hollywood. And we had the opportunity to collaborate with him on another project, and we're so impressed with him. When we read this article, we just thought, man, this is a very difficult movie to pull off. We need somebody of Matt's caliber. So we sent the article to him, and thankfully he responded. And not only did he respond, but he responded so passionately that he was like, not only do I want to write this, but I want to direct it as well. Can this be my first directing effort? And we were thrilled to be able to partner with him like that.
Congratulations on breaking the box office record. That's a pretty special thing. I think the question fans have is, are you guys really going to walk away from Marvel? Because you've been such a huge part in guiding that into the amazing thing that it has now become.
Look, the work we've done with Marvel is among the best work we've ever done in our lives. We're very proud of it. We're very grateful for it. And our partnership, our collaboration with Marvel Studios has been amazing. Everyone there is so talented and so exciting for us to work with. I mean, I'm sure at some point we will collaborate with them again, but our job on Endgame was to really bring a sense of closure to what we've known as the MCU up until this point. And I think it was very important for Joe and I to only be thinking about the road that we've all traveled with the MCU up until this moment in time and not thinking about the future. It was very creatively liberating for Joe and I for the first time in 7 years after 4 Marvel movies to not be thinking about the future of where Marvel storytelling can go, but simply be thinking about how do we give audiences and ourselves the most satisfying conclusion to the story. And so I think it was very important that we did that, and we sort of separated ourselves from where the future would go, at least for the time being.
I'm curious, as the people who finally brought Spider-Man into the MCU with the amazing Tom Holland, how do you feel about that situation, which seems to be a little bit more complex than it was when you guys had
Well, I'll say this, it was extremely difficult for us to be able to reintroduce the character of Spider-Man in Civil War and find a way for Sony and Disney to partner on that. And all credit to Kevin Feige, the head of Marvel Studios, for being able to pull off a very difficult marriage of two big Hollywood studios who are basically competitors of one another. But they were able to find a way to share that character for those films. And Joe and I are very, very grateful for the opportunity to have made movies with that character and to have relaunched that character. But we knew it was a difficult marriage. It's hard to get two big studios to cooperate with one another. So the fact that the marriage is falling apart, frankly, isn't that surprising to us, even though it's sad for fans. But I just have to look back and say that I'm very, very grateful for the opportunity that we had with the character.
You talked to us a bit about how excited you are to be working with Chadwick. I know your company's supporting him in his future endeavor.
Yes, and that, by the way, 21 Bridges is the other script of ours that Matt Carnahan wrote on. So we're very proud of the work that Matt contributed to 21 Bridges as well. But yes, Chadwick is one of the most amazing actors we've ever worked with. We're so proud to be able to introduce that character of Black Panther to the MCU and cast Chadwick in that role. And our collaboration with him has been amazing. So the fact that we can move forward now with him and sort of find another way to celebrate him as a fantastic leading actor. I mean, 21 Bridges is a really exciting story for my brother and I. We've always been a fan of like the classic New York City cop films, Sidney Lumet movies, and this is 21 Bridges is in that tradition. It's a sort of a classic New York City police corruption story, but with very, very modern themes and sensibilities. And it speaks, I think, very poignantly to a lot of very complicated things that are happening today.
We love you, 3001.
Oh, that's really cool. That's beautiful.